talk about how fusion has something to do with our cell phones?
Yeah, this surprises people when I bring it up. So we've done a lot of work in the fusion research field, and every time you do research, you get kind of unexpected results that can kind of lead to new areas of, you know, new development in technology. So the conditions to get two particles to fuse together requires a lot of energy. So you have to heat up the particles hot enough that they stick together to fuse. And at these temperatures, if you heat up a gas and you keep adding heat to it, matter goes into the fourth state of matter, which is called the plasma state. So you have like this electrically charged gas. And so what we learned as a field is you can actually make this plasma and use it for a whole field called plasma processing, which they use to transform how we make transistors and computer chips. So that's why your phone and computers are portable now, is from spin-off technology from fusion energy. Looking into the next phase of human technology, I think that's where fusion energy could be the source for the next phase of human technology. And then if you go beyond extending from our Earth, right now we rely on chemical rockets, which requires a lot of resources, you know, resources that we have on Earth. And you can look at what if we transform how we power space travel by using fusion, which relies on hydrogen, an abundant element. Fusion is also has much higher energy density, so you can go a lot faster and farther with fusion energy potentially.